All right, let's transition to the National Football League. Earlier this week, yesterday to be specific, we gave you some, I believe, running back props that we were very fond of. If we have a graphic, let's take a look at what we fired away. Elliott for you, Harris for me were picks on Monday, and then we laid out three each that we like for this coming season. I like Darrell Henderson now that the Cam Akers injury has thrust him to a more marquee role. Aaron Jones, Antonio Gibson, I love that. I think Washington, a lot of people are sleeping on Washington. And if you're bullish on Washington right now, you could reap some big rewards in a variety of different ways come the end of the season. So today we're going to turn our attention to the pass catchers, tight ends, wide receivers, three each. We're going to go back and forth. You lead it off.
You know, I don't like unders, so these are all overs here. And this is a name I've mentioned before, Robert Woods, though his line has moved from 1,000.5 to 1,025.5. This is about the upper range of where I'd go over. But bottom line is, big boost with Matt Stafford and the Cam Akers injury probably skews a little slightly more towards the passing. And of all the wide receivers Sean McVay has, Robert Woods is the most well-rounded, and he's the one who's least likely to get hurt. Hasn't missed a game due to injury since 2017, and 10 out of 16 games last year, 90-plus percent of offensive snaps because he can run every route. He can block in the run game. He will be on the field more than any other wide receiver for Matt Stafford to throw to. That's why I like going over here.
Number one, George Kittle, over 1,050.5 receiving yards. He's done this in two of the last 3 years. Last year, he didn't because he was injured. Injuries are a concern, but he did do it 2 years ago despite playing only 14 games. He gets the 17th game this season. That's one good reason. Number two, the rise of Brandon Ayuk and Deebo Samuel at wide receiver is going to take a lot of the attention away from Kittle. And Kyle Shanahan is a master at scheming up plays to get Kittle open. For as good as George Kittle is, and for as much as the league knows about it, the dude runs wide open down the field way too often. Shanahan is a genius with that. Jimmy Garoppolo loves him. Trey Lance, when he starts, is going to need to lean on him. George Kittle, over 1,050.5 receiving yards. Next up.
All right, let's go to that Cincinnati passing game that I love so much. I think T. Higgins' numbers are a little soft in the market because of how excited, for good reason, everyone is over Ja'Marr Chase joining this team. But last year as a rookie, T. Higgins caught 6 touchdown passes and 908 yards worth of catches with Joe Burrow there only half the season. Now he has more weapons that defenses have to worry about. He's in his second year, and Burrow is back. So I'm over on 5.5 TDs, over on 1,000.5 yards. And if there were bets to prop slip, who's going to lead the Cincinnati Bengals in all these receiving categories, I'd hammer T. Higgins because I think most people are going to say, it's got to be Ja'Marr Chase. They just invested the fifth overall pick, and he's the shower buddy of Joe Burrow from LSU. T. Higgins is the guy who's going to be the number one threat. Ja'Marr Chase will be number two for that team next year.
Let's go to the Denver Broncos. Cortland Sutton over 975.5 receiving yards. This is a buy low proposition right here. Sutton only played 31 snaps last year before he tore his ACL. So as a result, his prop is going to be very, very low. This, ladies and gentlemen, is how we find value. 2 years ago as a sophomore, 1,112 receiving yards. Okay, so it's something he's done before, and he's already played with Joe Flacco, Case Keenum, Drew Locke, Brandon Allen. Now he gets more experience from Drew Locke, or he gets Teddy Bridgewater, an experienced, successful quarterback.
Love that.
Jerry Jeudy and other wide receivers around him are going to give him favorable coverage matchups. Cortland Sutton over 975.5, number three.
Like his over touchdown prop as well, which I think is also 5.5. He's a touchdown machine, Sutton. Allen Robinson over 1,125.5 yards for the Bears wide receiver. He's cleared this threshold each of the past two seasons with the Bears, with Nick Foles and Mitch Trubisky as his quarterback. Now, Andy Dalton maybe makes a start or two, but Justin Fields should be starting the majority of the games. And for rookie quarterbacks, you know they're going to look at the best target on their team more often than not. If they're in trouble, just throw it to Allen Robinson.
Yeah.
And there is no one else on the Bears wide receiver or tight end room that is a threat to his mega alpha air yard share and target share. Allen Robinson is going to get looks. If he stays healthy, he should smash this, especially with the quarterback boost and Justin Fields, if and when he starts playing.
Sorry, Bills Mafia. Number three, Stephon Diggs, under 1,375.5 receiving yards. This, as opposed to what we just did with Cortland Sutton as a buy low, is a sell high. This is a ridiculously high number. The Bills are great. Diggs is great. But this number is massive. In 6 NFL seasons, Diggs has eclipsed this number one time, and it was last year. All right, so now as a result, the number is inflated. There's an opportunity to go with the under. Buffalo's not going to sneak up on anybody this season. Everyone knows they can pass. Everyone knows Diggs is a stud. There's going to be tight coverage matchups week in and week out. I think the team's going to be good. I think the players are going to be good. I think the number's too high, which is why I'm playing the under.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.